Hello, welcome to California State University, Los Angeles. Over the next 10 minutes, we'll be going over lab safety points. At California State LA, the Environmental Health and Safety Office ensures that students and faculty are aware of safety issues while working on campus labs. Since the safety is of the utmost concern, there's four major things that you need to know before you do an experiment within a laboratory. Number one, know the hazards. For instance, is it a flammable or is it an acid? Number two, know the worst things that could happen. This means knowing the hazards that are present with whatever work you are doing in the lab. Number three, know what to do if something should happen. And number four, identify and use prudent practices and protective equipment needed to minimize the risks. Enjoy.
First things first, you must have on proper clothing and personal protective equipment. One, you should wear long sleeve shirts and long pants to minimize skin exposure. Your clothing should be easily removed in case of an accident. Two, your shoes should be flat and closed-toed. Uppers made with real or synthetic leather are best. Three, you must tie long hair back. Loose clothing and jewelry should not be worn. Pay particular attention to rings, as they may damage gloves when you put them on. One, always have on safety goggles to protect your eyes from fumes and splatters. Regular and safety glasses are not sufficient. Two, you must wear protective apron or lab coat to cover your torso and arms as appropriate. If you are using chemicals that are highly corrosive or flammable, you may need an apron or lab coat made of different materials. Your instructor or TA can assist. Three, you must always wear appropriate gloves when required. Use the appropriate material and gauntlet length gloves based on your activities and your instructor's directions. Do not reuse gloves. Number four, to prevent cross-contamination of the outside environment with your work environment, you must always remove all protective equipment and thoroughly wash your hands before leaving the lab. You must always take off your gloves and wash your hands before handling things like phones, doorknobs, books, and pens.
For emergencies requiring fire department or rescue squad, dial 911 or campus police at 323-343-3700. In the event of an injury or chemical splash, it is crucial to know where to locate each piece of safety equipment in the lab, as well as two exits. Let's go over some of the injuries or chemical splash situations and learn how to react in these situations. In the event of an eye injury or chemical splash, use the eye wash immediately. Help the injured person by holding their eyelids open while rinsing. Rinse copiously and have your eyes checked by the student health center or a private physician. Use a safety shower in the event of a chemical spill. Pull the overhead handle and remove clothing that may be contaminated with chemicals to allow the skin to be rinsed. You should rinse for 15 minutes. A fume hood carries away vapors from reagents or reactions you may be working with. Using a fume hood correctly will reduce your personal exposure to potentially harmful fumes or vapors. When using a fume hood, keep the following in mind. Place equipment or reactions as far back in the hood as it is practical, while being mindful to not block the vents, the rear of the fume hood. This will improve the efficiency of fume collection and removal. Turn on the light inside the hood using the switch on the outside panel near the electrical outlets.
Transporting chemicals is dangerous for the individual undertaking the transport, as well as innocent bystanders unaware of the hazards. When chemicals are carried, they should be placed in a safety container, acid carrying bucket, or other appropriate secondary container to protect against breakage and spillage. When they are transported on a wheeled cart, the cart should have wheels large enough to negotiate uneven surfaces without tipping or stopping suddenly. Hazardous chemicals should be transported on freight elevators whenever possible, so as to avoid exposure to persons on passenger elevators. Always try to transport chemicals with a buddy, with one person wearing gloves to protect and handle the chemicals, and the buddy ungloved and opening doors and pressing elevator buttons. If transporting alone, wear one glove to handle or hold chemicals, with the other hand ungloved to open doors and press elevator buttons. Proper and appropriate PPE should be worn when transporting chemicals. When spills occur, prevent them from spreading by using absorbent pads or paper towels. When available, spill neutralizers are used for spills on floors and benchtops. If neutralizers are used, allow for appropriate contact time before cleanup. All cleanup materials are disposed as hazardous waste and do not go into the regular trash. Contact your instructor or TA immediately when spills occur. Your lab should have an assembled spill kit, which is tailored to clean small spills and other commonly used chemicals. It should be stocked and easily accessible. You should familiarize yourself with its location. Please, absolutely no eating or drinking in the labs.
Make sure everyone working in the lab knows locations of fire extinguishers, manual pull stations, eyewashes, emergency showers, and telephones.
Despite taking all of these safety measures, accidents can still happen. In case of an accident, use the lab's fire extinguisher to put out small lab fire. Alert your instructors and or TA and others around you. Do not clean up broken glass with your hands, only with the proper equipment. In the event of any spills to your clothing or skin, use a safety eye wash and safety shower for 15 minutes to remove chemicals. Then contact the Student Health Center. Call 911,
dial 911 or campus police at 323-343-3700. Please note that dialing 911 from a cell phone will connect you to the California Highway Patrol. Dialing 911 from a landline phone in the lab will connect you to campus police.
Throughout the video, we went over proper clothing, personal protective equipment, lab equipment, transporting chemicals, spill cleanup, and accident reporting. Always remember that in case of any emergency, use the nearest exit. If you have any questions, you may contact the EH&S office at 323-343-3531. And most importantly, stay calm and reassess the situation before making a decision. Thank you for listening to this presentation.